So, to answer Jarrah's question, what do we know and what can we prove? We have an LRO photo that shows something casting a shadow at the exact spot that NASA claims the Apollo 15 landed. Could it be a boulder? Sure. Aliens conducting some seismic experiment probably dropped a boulder right smack dab on top of where the descent stage should be. Why not? Was the shadow composited into the photo? Sure. Although, all the whistleblowers working for NASA in the 60s have long since retired. Their grandchildren have probably taken up the whistleblowing responsibility. I can't see any other explanation for a shadow to be in the photo. But seriously, folks, we have a false color composite photo showing a dark splotch in the exact spot where NASA claims the Apollo 15 landed. The black spot indicates a peak in the amount of iron oxide in that area. That's all. It's not a blast crater. It's not visible to the naked eye. It's just dust. Dust that's been stirred up. Does this disprove the validity of the LRO photo? No. The scientists at Brown University theorized that this peak in iron is due to the lunar module's descent engine stirring up, not blasting away, a thin layer of dust over an area the size of about 16 football fields, without the end zones. That's the theory. Believe it or leave it. Your choice. Either way, does this disprove the validity of the LRO photo? No. We have an image of the east slope of a crater near where NASA claims that the Apollo 15 lunar module landed. Does that disprove the validity of the LRO photo? No. The folks at JAXA calculated somehow that the east wall of this crater is brighter than other craters in the area. Does that disprove the validity of the LRO photo? No. These same scientists then theorized that the exhaust from the lunar module's descent engine brightened the crater up when it passed near or over the crater. Does that disprove the validity of the LRO photo? No. The astronauts didn't blow up the descent stage after they left the moon. Does that disprove the LRO photo? No. Except for directly below the lunar module, we have the lack of any oh-so-obvious disturbance in the Apollo 15 photos due to the exhaust plume stirring up dust during the landing. Does that disprove the LRO photos? No. We have no blast crater under the lunar module in any of the Apollo 15 photos. Does that disprove the LRO photo? No. So, we have an LRO photo that cannot be discredited except by saying something completely stupid like, whistleblowers working inside NASA photoshopped the shadow into the photo to alert hoax conspiracists everywhere that the photo is a fake. That cannot be disproved. Can't be proved either, and any claim of duplicity is not a valid argument. Face it, the moon hoax conspiracists have nothing credible they can throw out to discredit the LRO photos. The only proof this MoonFaker video provides is that you have to be delusional to believe in any hoax conspiracy theories, and there's nothing, nothing that an unobservant propagandist like I can say that will change their minds. As a parodic postscript to the debunking of Jarrah's video, MoonFaker, LRO, Selene, and Clementine, I have one last important observation to make. After careful analysis of Jarrah's video, I have determined that Jarrah is no more a hoax conspiracist than I am. In fact, I have uncovered undeniable evidence that Jarrah is actually a hoax conspiracy whistleblower's whistleblower. You can tell this is so because of the clues he left in his last video. I'll try to point out as many as I can, but of course, being an unobservant propagandist, I probably missed quite a few. When Jarrah said that the Clementine images were recorded in the ultraviolet spectrum, he knew that was wrong because he'd already seen the photos on the JPL website and he knew which filters were used. Instead, he intentionally said ultraviolet because he knew that the Apollo 15 command module Endeavour was the only one fitted with a UV filter over one of the windows. This permitted the astronauts to take ultraviolet pictures of the Earth and the Moon throughout their trip. Here, Jarrah is hinting at a unique feature of the Apollo 15 mission. Why would he do that if he believed the mission was a fake? When Jarrah used a negative image to describe the difference between pictures taken in the UV and visible light spectrums, he was telling us that he knew the picture in the article was a negative image. That's obvious, because he shows a positive image in his video at the 324 and 537 markers. He was giving a clue on how to debunk his argument. While we're on this photo, another obvious clue is our old friend, the arrow graphic. How many arrows did Jarrah draw in this photo? 13, of course, because the Apollo 13 was the only Apollo mission that did not actually land on the moon. What other explanation is there for him to do this? In the passage that Jarrah quotes from Bill Kaysing's book, We Never Went to the Moon, Kaysing is listing the things that the astronauts could have done to tell the world they were there. If you look at the parts Jarrah blacked out, you'll see that this particular item is about setting a timer on the descent engine and blowing it up after the astronauts left, with whatever fuel remains in the descent engine's fuel canisters, so that the world could look up and see the flash of light and know they were there. That would also destroy all the experiments they left behind, but who cares about science anyway? This has got to be the most ridiculous suggestion Kaysing ever made. But Jarrah manages to tie this in with the Apollo 3 unmanned spacecraft, which was intentionally detonated by radio at high altitude. Nobody saw that explosion either. Again, Jarrah associates this video with another Apollo mission. Why? In describing the lunar module descent stage, he calls it a 3,000-pound thrust engine. It is actually a 10,000-pound thrust engine. Jarrah knows that. The lunar module itself weighed less than 3,000 pounds after burning its fuel by the time it reached the surface. So 3,000 pounds of thrust would keep the lunar module from landing, as would 10,000 pounds. If you add 10,000 and 3,000, you get 13,000. Again, a reference to the Apollo 13 mission being the only one that did not land on the moon. There is no other plausible explanation for Jarrah to do this. Jarrah gives several other hints on how to debunk his video, but again, we're running out of time. There isn't much need to go further into this anyway, since in the next couple of months, NASA will release the first major cluster of images from LRO. There should be several more photos with much more detail of the landing sites. We'll just have to wait for those images and see what the conspiracists have to say then. Ciao, moon hoax conspirators, wherever you are.